The governors of the Southeast geopolitical zone have expressed their readiness to unveil a security outfit for the region. They said the name of the security outfit would be made known to the public during the Southeast Governors Forum next meeting, adding that all the necessary arrangements for the takeoff of the outfit are on course. Joining us now is security expert Roy Okidiebe. Thank you very much for joining us. Quickly, we know that Amoteku is still very much around, but people are saying we don't seem to hear a lot more of the activities the way it was ushered in. What is your take on this new regional security outfit?
Well, thank you very much. Good morning, and thank you for the opportunity. Well, you see, during the time of the Amoteku, some of us came out to say Nigerian security industry has gone privatized. We are the private security practitioners. We have encouraged government all the time to come and parlay and liaise with the private security industry, because all of these things you want to do about security, if there's no continuity, if there's no synergy, if there's no source of regular funding, it will be a joke. And we said the Amoteku is a joke. Why? Because if you go on regional security, like the South East governors they want to do right now, if you go on that kind of security system, you will have the problem of synergy. You will have the problem of funding, because some of the governors may give funding this month and may not give next month. And before you know what's happening, payment of salaries will start to delay or maybe cut off. Imagine putting guns and opportunity and authority in the hands of people, and you can't fund them, motivate them properly. So we have looked at all of that, and we said this form of security is a joke. If you want to do it state by state and expect each state to liaise with a neighboring state and correlate security intelligence and operations together, backed up by the federal government security agency, then you have a win-win situation. But you are going regional, that means it is a source of funding positive that you are looking for.
But we do have security situation in parts of this country that seem to defy efforts by the federal government. Don't you see any positives in this move?
The security situations that we have in Nigeria, let me tell you, is just the dilapidation of governance, destruction of governance. Okay, let me give you the nuts for an example. You see all these imaginary children that have grown into banditry, that have grown into terrorism, drug addiction, and all that. Same thing we are doing in the South East. Because all of these universities are churning out graduates every day. And these graduates don't have jobs, don't have prospects, don't have future. They don't have the most important quotient, which is mentorship. There is nobody they look at like a legacy. So before you know what's happening, they go into cyber crime, they go into Yahoo Plus ritual activities, they go into drug addiction, and they engage in cultism. You know, so once you have all of this as the burning embers, what governors need to focus on right now is to remove the things that causes the flame. Once you can enrich the content of employment, when you can enrich engaging youth in cyber security, cyber activity, when you can create centers where there are free Wi-Fi for them to come and exercise themselves into creating blogs, into creating apps, you will be shocked what we will turn up in Nigeria, especially in the South East. Then you have to cut off supply of drugs. You use the NDLA, you use your local content, cut off supply of drugs, and make cultism become unattractive. And from there, you begin to have support from government security agencies.
Let's look at the timing of this announcement. You alluded to it that there should be some other focus other than this now. Is it more a problem of timing and planning, like you've also mentioned, or it's more to do with the politics of the situation?
There is no criminal activity going on in the South-South right now, South-East, South-West, that has not been there for decades. There is none. There's no new one. There's cyber crime. There's all of it. Kidnapping, cultism. It has been going on. And we know the flashpoint. It's city to city, state by state. So let me agree with you that the timing is specific to their choice. But I still assure the public that the timing is wrong. Okay, look at the timing of the Amotekun, which is a dead example right now. Then, do you remember they bought vehicles, they did a flash campaign on the internet and everywhere. Then the police came in that they are bringing community policing and everybody should go and register for community policing. And before we know what's happening, COVID struck. In the melee of the COVID, there were cases of hoodlums taking over a whole estate. Hoodlums marauding and stealing and robbing people, raping at one time. Where was the Amotekun that should have been like 60% set up already because they have uniforms, they have vehicles? Where were those community security systems set up? Because they collapsed. That means there was no active presence in the community. So my advice to everybody is partner with your security private practitioners. That is the way to keep it going. That is the way to ensure continuity.
Are you talking from experience? Because we do know that some of these partnerships might end up becoming more of a problem for us, private security firm and the government. How is that going to work, really, in trying to manage the security architecture of this country? Let's not just focus on the South-South now.
It has worked so many times. Look at Iraq. Look at what Blackwater is doing and so many other private security companies in the West, which we copy. Look at the federal government regulation on private security. We have licenses. If you misbehave or you go out of ethics, they will cancel your license. The Civil Defense and the Ministry of Interior, they are the ones managing private security practice in Nigeria. And with the government backup, with regulations and ethics and compliance, they will be able to put in place. And because of competition, if it's your opportunity to take up a job, to monitor a community or wherever, you will put CCTV there, you will ensure that there is patrolling, and you will ensure that there is liaison with the community system in place to be able to generate intelligence and call up government backup where necessary, the DSS, the police, the immigration, NDLA, any of them you want to call up. So because you know you have something at stake, you have a corporate image to keep, and you have your license to protect.
I think you've made your argument, Mr. Roy Okidiave. Thank you very much for the insights you've provided.
Thank you very much. Yeah.